Welcome to Inspirational Retreats with Shari. I'm your host, Dr. Shari, and I'm delighted that you tuned in again this week. Today is the pre-holiday eve, or the 4th of July eve. Today is Friday, July the 3rd, 2015, and God has another special message just for you. So, as always, let's pray. Most gracious and all-wise God, creator of heaven and earth, Lord, we first come before your throne with thanksgiving. Lord, thanking you for all the many blessings that you bestow upon our lives. Father God, we just thank you right now for your word. Father God, we thank you for your son, Jesus the Christ, who is the living word. And Lord, we just thank you that you give us a heart to want to learn more about him, to learn more about you. And Father God, I just thank you right now, as you change the words of my mouth, and Father God, regulate the meditation of my heart so that it is acceptable in your sight, so that your people hear your word and are forever changed. Lord, we love you and we bless your holy name. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you, dear hearts. Thank you for tuning in again this week. And so, as we prepare to celebrate Independence Day in the United States, God has a special message for you entitled, Let Freedom Ring. Yes, let freedom ring. Let it ring inside your heart. Usually we hear church bells as they ring. They announce births or deaths or weddings or the beginning of a service or certain aspects of our history that's important, so that all the townspeople, they hear the bells ringing. They hear the bells ringing. And so the freedom bells are ringing this day because God has given us freedom in his son Jesus Christ. Yes, we live in the United States, or at least that's where I'm coming to you from. You may be anywhere in the world. And so, no matter where you are, you may be in bondage or you may be in freedom. But Jesus died so that we all can be made free, made spiritually free. And so, this day, know that you can let freedom ring. Let it ring in your heart. Let's jump into God's word and find out a little more about God's freedom. And we'll look at Acts chapter 2 and just a few short verses. We'll be looking at verses 36 through 41. So let's read it. Acts chapter 2, starting with verse 36. And this is Peter's sermon right after the Holy Spirit had come upon him and the others who were in the upper room. And then those who were in the city, those that were of Judea, they thought, oh, they're drunken with wine. And Peter's letting them know, well, that can't be because it's still early in the morning. And then those who were Hellenists, they actually knew some of the languages that they were speaking, because they were speaking with tongues that they did not know how to speak. They were speaking in languages that they did not know. And so the Hellenists, when they heard it, it's like, wow, we hear that they're speaking in a tongue or a dialect or communicating in a language that they know nothing about. That has got to be a miracle from God. And so Peter, he goes on to preach to the people who were there so that they would know about Jesus Christ and him crucified and how he is alive. And now he has given the Holy Spirit. We should let freedom ring, hallelujah, because this day we have God's Holy Spirit that can dwell on the inside of us. But there are a couple of things that we need to do first before we can receive his Holy Spirit. So let's read his word. And he gave Peter the utterance to preach. And then we believe that Luke, the apostle Luke, actually wrote Acts. And so Luke is taking down the information here so that we can have it today to reflect back on and to know that God's word is true. So, starting in Acts chapter 2, verse 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made the same Jesus whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Verse 37. Now when they had heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Now, what a question. That is a question that everyone should ask. It's not what shall we do, as in how can we work to be saved, but what shall we do to receive the Holy Spirit? What shall we do to be saved? What shall we do to worship God? What shall we do to recognize Jesus as Lord and Master? What shall we do? And Jesus, and I'm sorry, Peter says to them, then Peter said in verse 38, said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. The first thing is to repent. When you hear God's preached word, as you hear his preached word this day, letting freedom ring in your heart, hallelujah, as you hear his preached word, then you believe on Jesus Christ, that he died on a cross for your sin and for mine, and we couldn't pay the sin debt ourselves, that Jesus Christ, who is the Son of God, he came, led a sinless life, he was tempted, he was fully man and fully God, he was tempted on every hand, but yet he did not sin, and then he was put on a cross, and he gave up his life for you and for me. And because of him, we now have a right to the tree of life. We now can be reconciled to God. All we have to do is, in our hearts, repent. Repent, being godly sorry. Godly sorry for those things that we have done. We have been trekking in the pathway toward our own understanding. We've been trekking in the pathway to whatever selfish desires we have had, and we've totally ignored Jesus Christ. We've been trekking in that way. But then once we hear the word of God, then we can turn around, turn from that direction, and turn to Jesus Christ. That is repenting. Making a 180 degree turn away from the way you want to go, the way you want to live your life, the way you think is right, to only the way that Jesus Christ has told us to live. And that's to acknowledge him as our Lord and our Christ, as the Savior of the world. And when you recognize him, you repent in your heart. That means you're godly sorry for what you have done against Jesus, what you have done against God, and then turn to him. And then after you turn to him, knowing that that's an inward, so people can't really see what's going on in the inside of your heart, but as an outward show, you would actually be baptized. That means to be totally immersed, submerged in water, as an outward demonstration of the love for God, the love of Jesus, the obedience that you have to his word, to be baptized. That's what God wants us to do. First, we repent, we believe on his son Jesus Christ, and repent. They go hand in hand. Then, as an outward show of that, to show that we are part of God's family, that we truly believe in who Jesus is, then we are baptized. Typically, I don't talk about that because I always say, now, going to, after you repent, you accept Jesus as the Lord of your life, then get into a great Bible-teaching, Bible-believing church. Bible-teaching, Bible-believing churches will give you the Word of God, and also let you know what the ordinances of God are, those things that we need to carry out in our lives. And baptism, water baptism, is one of those ordinances. And so as you get into a Bible-teaching, Bible-believing church, then godly wisdom, there'll be people there who will give you great wisdom, great counsel, so that you know when you should be baptized by water and how you should be baptized by water. God will lead you to the right places. But the number one thing that you need to know this day to let freedom ring is that you repent in your heart. You truly believe in your heart. Everything that we do when it comes to the kingdom of God, our spiritual beings, is in our heart, not in the fleshy heart. Sometimes I have children ask me, they're like, in the beady heart, like a heart, like you cut out a heart for Valentine's. No, not even the flesh part of your heart, but it's actually the center of who you are. In the very center of who you are, you know in your heart, not just in your mind or what you're thinking, but in your very heart, you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and that He died on a cross for your sins, and that because He did so successfully, because He's God Himself, now you can be reconciled to God the Father, knowing that Jesus has already finished it all, that you don't have to add to it or do anything to it except for believe in His finished work. And then, as an outward demonstration of that, you are baptized. So once you're baptized, and you are baptized not only into water, you will be baptized into the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You don't have to do these things to be saved. You do them because you are saved. And so God, He is looking to you this day to have that independence, to celebrate independence and let freedom ring. You can't truly have freedom in this world until you're free in Jesus. All you have to do is believe on Jesus Christ, repent this day, and then get into a great Bible teaching, Bible believing church so they can lead you and direct you as to when to be baptized by water, and God's Holy Spirit will surely baptize you in the Spirit. You are now a part of the family. And so there are certain things, there are rights and privileges to being in a family. Just like we have a natural family and you have rights and privileges, like you can come into the dining room and eat when you want to as a part of the family. There are even greater benefits to being a part of God's spiritual family. God loves you this day. He sent Jesus Christ. He loved you before He cleaned you. He loved you before you even knew who you were. He loves you this day. Let it be Independence Day or any other regular day of the year. He loves you. And every day you can live free in Jesus. Why don't you let freedom ring in your heart this day? God loves you so much. Let me finish out a couple of the verses that we said we would cover. And verse 39 says, "For the promise is unto you and to your children, and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord God shall call." So it doesn't just stop with you. The family is big. It can go to your children. No better or no greater joy than to have your children and your grandchildren and their children, on and on and on throughout all the generations, to call on the name of the Lord and be free. God is so good. He says, "For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are afar off." Verse 40, "And with many other words did He testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation." All you have to do is turn on the news. You actually don't even have to turn on the news. Whenever you're at the gas station, the bank, the grocery store, wherever you are, just you could be in a park, you could be at the beach, you can be anywhere. You can see evil going on. And it is a sad generation. But there is hope. There is hope in Jesus. So God is inviting you this day to be a part of His family so that everywhere you go, you shed the light of Jesus on this dark and untowered generation. And then verse 41 says, "Then they that gladly received His word were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls." I love how it says, "And they that gladly received the word were baptized." They that gladly received. Why don't you Be glad this day. This is the day the Lord hath made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We can be glad in it because Jesus reigns. Because Jesus reigns, we can be set free. All you have to do is gladly receive, gladly believe. Repent with your heart, not just with your mouth, but repent in your heart. And then be ye baptized. God loves you this day. Why don't you say this simple yet effective prayer with me? And say this prayer with me. Most gracious and all-wise God, creator of heaven and earth, Lord, I just love you and I thank you. I ask you to come into my heart, totally change me. Change me from that path of destruction that I was on to have hope and trust and faith in you. Lord, I am so sorry for all the wrong that I have done. I ask you to clean me now and make me whole. I receive you as the Lord of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you just said that simple yet beautiful prayer with me, God, he heard it. He heard it from your heart. And now you are saved. Please do get into a great Bible-teaching, Bible-believing church so you can give that demonstration, that outward demonstration of the love you have now for Jesus as you are baptized to demonstrate that you are part of his family. God bless you and continue to let freedom ring in your heart. Be blessed.